सदाशिवसमारम्भां ज्ञानसम्बन्धमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। I welcome you all with my love and respects. मैं आप सबका प्रेम व आशीर्वाद सहित स्वागत करता हूँ। स्वागत है सभी भक्तों का, शिष्यों का, समाजियों और सत्संगियों का, जो विश्व के कोने कोने से इस समय 573 जगह से शामिल हैं नित्यानंद टीवी लाइव द्वारा, 35 जगह से टू वे वीडियो कॉन्फ्रेंसिंग द्वारा नयन दीक्षा प्राप्त कर रहे हैं। इस समय दुनिया भर के 254 शहरवा 30 देशों से लोग जुड़े हैं वर्तमान अंकों के अनुसार। इस समय जो शहर हमारे साथ टू वे वीडियो कॉन्फ्रेंस द्वारा नयन दीक्षा में जुड़ हैं, वे हैं चेन्नई आलवारपेट, फिनिक्स कांचीपुरम, ग्वाडलूप रामेश्वरम, टोरंटो कैलासम, मलेशिया पड़नी, ओहायो प्रयाग, तिरुवण्णामलै अरुणाचलम, सैन होसे मदुरै, सियाटल चिदंबरम, हैदराबाद बाह्यनगरम, अडयार चेन्नई, ओहायो माशिवानंद, लॉस एंजलिस अरुणाचलम, शारजा, बेंगलुरु नित्यानंद विद्यालय, ब्लैक डायमंड कनाडा, लास्पेट पांडिचेरी, दुबई तिरुकोविलूर, ओमन शिवगंगई, महाकुंभपुरी प्रयाग, बेंगलुरु गंगम्मा सर्कल, हैदराबाद श्री, हांगकांग सीरगाड़ी, देवोन यूके, शिकागो श्रीरंगम, सिंगापुर सिंगापुरम, चार्लट श्रीशैलम, न्यूयॉर्क वाराणसी, पोर्ट वाशिंगटन न्यूयॉर्क, लंदन काशी, पेरिस कालीघाट, वैंकूवर पुरी, बेंगलुरु नॉर्थ, बेंगलुरु मारत्तहल्ली, दैट्स इट। व्हाट हैपेंड टू वीसी सिटीज? ओ बिकॉज निराहार है, सो लास्पेट पांडिचेरी, दुबई तिरुकोविलूर, ओमन शिवगंगई, आई रीड आउट ऑल दैट। ऑस्टिन, यस ऑस्टिन आई कैन सी नाउ, यस। और टुडे शिवांगी हैज कम टू गिव दर्शन फॉर मी, थैंक यू। आई वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू विद माय लव एंड ब्लेसिंग्स। टुडे वी हैव अ ग्रेट न्यूज, ब्रेकिंग न्यूज, High Court of Karnataka quashes 2 cases against Swamiji Paramahamsa Nityananda. High Court of Karnataka yesterday quashed the action initiated by the District Commissioner of Ramnagara against Swamiji in a case filed on June 14th, 2012. High Court of Karnataka clearly observed that the District Commissioner had acted illegally and without authority in remanding Paramahamsa Nityananda to custody as well as in obtaining a bond from Swamiji. The High Court of Karnataka also quashed the complaint filed by Karnataka Navanirman Sene, Bhima Shankar Patil and Sivaraja on 7th June 2012. High Court clearly said that no offence is made out in the case and hence the case is quashed. The false complaint was filed by Karnataka Navanirman Sene, the rowdy elements led by Bhima Shankar Patil against Swamiji in June 2012, claiming he had instigated his devotees and allegedly attacked them when in fact he was not even on the scene and Swamiji's disciples and sannyasis and sannyasinis were actually attacked and physically assaulted by these rowdy elements of Karnataka Navanirman Sene led by Bhima Shankar Patil. Today, fourth batch, Di Samyama, 10th day, and 15th Inner Awakening, and 12th Ingenious, 10th day. Continuously, so many questions on Krama Brahmacharya. Let me define it once for all, answering all the questions. Listen, first thing, you should be initiated into four tattvas and practicing it with excitement. Practicing it with excitement. That is the first step to get initiated into Krama Brahmacharya. And you literally follow all the vows practiced by sannyasis. Please listen. Krama Brahmacharya is nothing but literally living the vows of sannyas. After you become legally major, you can take sannyas, but till you become legally major, you are not authorized to make the final decision of sannyas. Even as per the Vedic tradition, they wait till your pratyagatma chaitanya jagrata happens, till your individual consciousness is awakened, till you spiritually become major, dharmically become major. Please listen, when your individual consciousness is awakened with completion, when you are not driven by patterns anymore, then you are dharmically major. And for various reasons, till you become legally major, you are not allowed to take sannyas. That is the reason this Krama Brahmacharya. Only one difference between sannyasis and Krama Brahmacharis is, in Krama Brahmacharya, you can drop your Brahmacharya and get married. But in Naishtika Brahmacharya and sannyas, it is irrevocable. Lifetime vow. Irrevocable, lifetime vow. Listen. सो ऑल क्रम ब्रह्मचर्य एप्लीकेंट्स लिसन लिटरली यू लिव द सेम कमिटमेंट्स ऑफ सन्यासीज ऑल द फाइव वाउस लाइक ब्रह्मचर्य अस्तेय अपरिग्रह सत्य अहिंसा with integrity authenticity responsibility and enrichment you also take up the same vows and live listen dhyan se suniye practicing all these five vows and the sanghas anyakara for any sannyasi is the lifestyle of krama brahmachari or naishthika brahmachari or sanyasi in krama brahmacharya you have only one exemption you can drop the brahmacharya vows sanyas vows at any time and get married or you can ask for naishthika brahmacharya and take sannyas there is no other difference and krama brahmacharis can continue their education till they complete Krama brahmacharis can study continue their either social education or spiritual education wherever they are staying in different places all over the world but only for the purpose of enriching others even during their education they practice enriching they prepare themselves for enriching all of you understand so they can study in different parts of the world just like in catholic churches even after they ordain somebody as a priest in monkhood he is sent to study they go and do some research in different universities and study same way you are already ordained now you are going just to study that is like a king going to school you know you tell them hey my life is not in the line of yours I am not in the competition race I have already decided different life I have come here just to enrich myself to enrich others That is exact way I went to college. If you see my sannyas initiation date and all the diksha dates, it's prior to college. They sent me just especially my guru Kuppammal used to tell. She'll tell, no, you have to study and know English. Only then you can teach people. So that is exactly way I went and same way the doubts about the kids taking brahmacharya krama brahmacharya you will not be able to perform any of the last rite rituals anybody in your family elders die please listen parents notice literally you are giving your son or daughter to become a sannyasi if you are allowing them to take krama brahmacharya literally you are giving them up to become a sannyasi or sannyasini later on if they change the decision that is between them and swamiji guru you have no role to play in that so from this moment you are no more owner you lose all the right. Please listen. When Rama, Lakshmana, Bharata, Shatrughna were handed over to Vasishta, they were handed over. Just because Dasaratha is giving cows as a Dakshina to Vasishta, he has no right to even to see the kids. And there is no guarantee the kids will come back to Dasaratha. If all four of them have decided to take sannyas, or Vasishta has decided to give sannyas to all four of them, they would not have even gone back to the palace. Over. But fortunately, Vasishta has decided they should go and rule the kingdom. And they also decided to go and rule the kingdom as per the orders of Vasishta. They went back. So listen. Understand the whole thing. And then apply for your Krama Brahmacharya or your son's Krama Brahmacharya. And if you are above the legal major age of your country, in some countries 18, some countries 21, am I right? If you are above the age of legal major, you can take only directly Naishthika Brahmacharya. Now you are authorized to decide, you cannot ask for Krama Brahmacharya. So many will fall in that category now. Ma, only if you are legally minor, you can take Krama Brahmacharya. They can. Then they have to reside in the campus. Yes, yes. They have to reside in the campus. Listen, when you take full kavi, you must be ready to fulfill my anyakara about full kavi. I wanted every person who is wearing kavi, this is my anyakara, listen, every person who has taken up kavi become the head of a pita, either I created or creating on your own. Each one of you guys should be able to inspire, enrich thousands of people to live these tattvas, and able to inspire them collectively to take up the responsibility of a pita. I am so happy for Seattle. Listen, I am just happy for Seattle as Mahakala Bhairava. I bless Seattle. They have sent their declaration. I'll read out completely. I really want to read out. Last night, Swamiji gave us an amazing blessing for us to come together in a shared responsibility. Listen, the word is not shared. Collective responsibility means, shared responsibility means each one is responsible for their responsibility. Collective responsibility means each one is responsibility for everyone's responsibility. Okay? There is a difference. Mukta, mark the difference. It is not shared responsibility. I said as collective responsibility, you heard as shared responsibility. Change that word. Okay? As on now, we are all working only in the mode of shared responsibility. That is why you do not even grasp the word collective responsibility. All of you listen, dhyan se suniye. Collective responsibility means everyone is responsible for everyone's responsibility. How many of you understand? So, Dhyana Peetam is supposed to run with the principle of collective responsibility, not shared responsibility. Okay. So, they have declared beautifully. They say, we declare this in front of Swamiji for His grace and blessings. With Sampurti, Shraddha, Upayanam and Apyayanam, integrity, authenticity, responsibility and goal of not goal. Enriching others and ourself. Enriching others and ourself is not a goal, it is lifestyle. You don't say with the goal of breathing, now I start telling my lungs and the heart to start vibrating. No. Breathing is not goal, it is lifestyle. Clear? So, remove that word. Yes. Now send this back to them as a blessing. What they offered is Nevedya, what I am sending back is Prasada. The Seattle Chidambaram Sangha declared that we are enriching the world by building a city Nityananda Puri. God. Muktananda, the name is approved. Nityananda Puri. Do it. Blessings. God. Which is, they are describing detailed way. Enriching life by being a self-sufficient Vedic community. Living the four tattvas as taught by Swamiji. Enriching lives by being built around the Seattle Chidambaram Temple, modeled after the original Chidambaram Temple, with all the Sangha members living inside the city. Enriching lives all over the world by being a place for Swamiji to live, as the Master, as a Dhamma and the Sangha. Wow! Enriching lives all over the world by being the center for renewal, an explosion of authentic yoga as intended by Swamiji, just like Patanjali enriched the world from old Chidambaram. Wow! Enriching the world by having a branch of Nityananda University. Enriching lives by connecting to the world through modern technology and to spread Swamiji's mission. Enriching lives with Annalaya, serving free nourishing food to thousands of people daily. Enriching the community by being a place for business to flourish based on four tattvas. Making the community self-contained. We have many more details worked out. Wow. We are following the schedule. We are building a temple by January 1st, 2015. We are building a self-contained community around the temple with Sangha members living there, where Swamiji can live with a business based on the four tattvas by January 1st, 2016. We are expanding into a full city with all facilities January 1st, 2018. We are studying places like Maharshi Vedic City in Iowa, getting inspired watching video on Belur Math and Ramakrishna Mission, how a small group of determined youth built it from the ground up. I bless you guys. All the energies, Lakshmi, Saraswati, Kali, Durga, Shiva, Shakti, Ganesha, Muruga, Vishnu, all the auspicious energies, including Nityananda, all of us will support you guys, grace you guys, and say, Tatastu. So be it. Let it be successful as per the timeline with all the auspiciousness. I tell you guys, now I commit to make the impossible into possible and break the idea of impossibility. Make the idea of only possibility, possibility, possibility. We can do it. We can do it. Create the presentation. Create the presentation. And keep the presentation in front of Paduka during every day of Pada Puja and Swasti Mantra. All of you send this wave of this project to the world through Swasti Mantra. It will become reality. It will become reality. It will become reality. Shared responsibility means each one is responsible for their responsibility. Collective responsibility means each one is responsible for everyone's responsibility. सेहा बातचीत जिम्मेदारी का अर्थ है कि हर व्यक्ति अपने व्यक्तिगत जिम्मेदारी के लिए खुद जिम्मेदार है. सामूहिक जिम्मेदारी का अर्थ आही कि हर व्यक्ति का व्यक्तिगत जिम्मेदारी लिए समूह में शामिल सभी लोग जिम्मेदार है. Now, Seattle Sangha, it is collective responsibility for all you guys, including me. I declare I am part of your Sangha. With responsibility, integrity, authenticity and enriching, I declare I am part of your Sangha. It is now collective responsibility of all of us. Thank you guys for setting up a trend of taking up impossibility as possibility. I know you guys are setting up a trend. Don't even think you are going to fulfill 99%. I assure you guys, we are going to do 100%. You don't know the power of collective responsibility because still you guys have not yet started playing that game. I wanted Sangha to play that game. Whatever may be your mood, get up, freshen up, show up. Okay? Only then you will be out of your mood swings. If you are lying down in your room, you are, oh, depression, you happened so beautifully for me. How can I leave you and go? I'll pour you little water and little food. Can we grow together? When you are in depression, don't be alone sitting in your room. If you are doing it, you are giving company to your depression and actively encouraging it. Actively encouraging it. Come to the Sangha. Be with the people who don't have depression, who will help you to come out of depression. Enrich yourself and enrich others. By the satsanga. Satsanga means a person who is always in the sat. Be in his sangha. Seattle guys, how many of you really feel now the excitement in your heart of this responsibility? Yes. Yes. Now all you guys are leaders. Listen. When I said Tathastu, it has already happened. How many of you are seeing now the whole Nityananda Puri in Seattle? Now you just need to work to make others see. The moment I said Tathastu, if you are seeing it, you are a spiritualist. You have to work to make materialists to see this city of Nityananda Puri. I tell you, even I did not imagine, even I did not have the anyakara that you guys will take up such big task. You guys have crashed my anyakara. So I will also crash your anyakaras about me. I'll fulfill and show me to you guys beyond your Anyakara. And I have a message from Malaysia. We have the same Sangha meeting this weekend, Saturday, for collective declaration for the Malaysia Sangha. It will be more exciting, enriching for Malaysia. Nirantara's blessing. Blessing. So before the Sangha meeting, I'll bless you guys. Okay? So that day, Saturday, gather all of you guys, gather for the morning satsang itself. I'll bless you guys in the morning satsang itself. Nirantara, I have the title of Nityananda Puri itself. You see, all over the world, standardize this name, Nityananda Puri. If you want to create a city, call it as Nityananda Puri. Or Nityananda Nagar. You can call it as Nityananda Nagar. Or Nityananda City. I have these 3-4 options. If you are in the Western countries, you can use the name as Nityananda City. I think even Seattle can use the word Nityananda City. That will be more apt. Shared responsibility means each one is responsible for fulfilling their own responsibility. Collective responsibility means each one is responsible for everyone's responsibility to the community.